Let's start today's episode with a quiz. Can you guess the amount of money lying unclaimed with Indian banks? The money I'm talking about here is the money lying in inoperative accounts such as saving accounts, current accounts, and fixed deposits. The answer is, it's a whopping 14,307 crore. This money is enough to buy more than 2,280 Lamborghinis or even a small-sized bank. This is the money lying in dormant accounts which people forget to claim when they change jobs or shift cities. Some of this is also money of people who passed away and their family members are not aware of existence of any such accounts. I am Dinesh Bhaseen from Mint's personal finance team. In this episode of Why Not Mint Money, we'll discuss how to get hold of the unclaimed money and what happens if you don't claim it for a long time. Let's start with what happens to the money if it remains unclaimed for a long time. If you don't claim the money for more than 10 years, banks transferred it to RBI's Depositors Education and Awareness Fund. The money is then invested in instruments such as government securities by a committee set up by RBI. The income earned is used for paying interest on deposits as well as for investor awareness and education purposes. As of March 2019, the money in this DEA fund was close to 25,000 crores. This is in addition to the 14,300 crores that we discussed lying with the banks unclaimed. But don't worry, an account holder can still get back the money which the bank has transferred to the Depositors Education and Awareness Fund. Banks are not only supposed to give you back your principal, but also the interest which you have earned on this money. As long as the money remains unclaimed, it keeps earning a nominal interest. So the question is, how do you claim your money? According to RBI's guideline, every bank is supposed to maintain details of unclaimed accounts on its website. So if you discover an old passbook or a deposit slip, approach your home branch with a duly filled claim form and also know your customer documents to claim the money. It is advisable that you visit the home branch where you had the account, especially if it's very old. You can either close the account permanently or even revive it. If you are a nominee or a legal heir of the account holder, you need to visit the home branch with the requisite documents such as your identity proof, deceased death certificate, succession certificate, and so on. The bank will make the payment to you after verifying all the documents and details. And at the end of the month, it will approach RBI to claim back the money from the DEA fund. Like it is said, prevention is better than cure. Why let your account become inoperative in the first place? Ideally, you should have two bank accounts other than your salary account. When your salary comes to your salary account, transfer the money to the two bank accounts. Keep one bank account for investment-related purpose and the other one for expenses. This way, you will be able to consolidate all your financial details. Use these three accounts to be organized. Also, put in some paperwork in place. Keep a record of your financial details. Make at least two people aware of it. One can be an immediate family member and the other can be someone who does not stay under the same roof. In case of a mishap, the other person can ensure the money goes to the right people. Inoperative and dormant bank accounts can be an easy target for dishonest bank employees. They can not only siphon off the money, but also use these bank accounts for illegal activities. You put in a lot of hard work to earn that money, so make sure you put it to the right use. That's all from this episode of Why Not Mint Money. Thank you for tuning in.